Let's listen to Ms. Sharada, a researcher aspiring to become an academician.
We know women are now making their mark in almost every phase of life, and they are asserting their identity and demanding for equal rights and opportunities. As a disabled woman, I have always felt that when we talk about gender equality, the specific needs and demands of women with disabilities are often neglected, even by women's organizations. According to many studies, it has been found that the prevalence of disability in women is higher than that of men. That is, about 1 in 5 women have disabilities. So we can actually guess the number of women with disabilities. Still, unfortunately, disabled women remain invisible and marginalized. They have to suffer double discrimination and double marginalization, more than the so-called able-bodied or non-disabled women. Actually, they have to face this kind of double discrimination and double marginalization based on their gender and their disability. That is, both this gender and disability, they are both considered as social constructions or the products of society. So in other terms, women with disabilities are the victims of the society or the products of society. And as a disabled woman, I consider myself as privileged and lucky because I could pursue my dreams despite my physical disability, overcoming lots of challenges and now pursuing PhD in English at University of Kerala. But like me, many other disabled women could not get opportunities for education and employment, which are actually, you know, imperative for their social and economic independence. So they are remaining invisible. They have to get confined within the four walls of their homes. So what I have felt is that when we talk about gender equality and women's issues, we have to consider the issues of disabled women also and think about the ways to solve their issues also. So that's all I have to share on this Women's Day.